Hello everyone, welcome to Youngistas. I am Abhilash Kshatriya. We have a fashion designer by passion, MC by profession, having hosted more than 2000 shows. Amazingly awesome, hot and happening host. My dear viewer friends, let's welcome Hera Pinto.
Hello everybody.
Hello,
and hi Abhilash. Thank you so much for having me on Youngistas. It's such an honor.
Yes.
Yes.
It's my pleasure also to invite you as the guest. In fact, hot and happening host.
wherever
we see the functions, it's going to be Hera Pinto all.
Nothing like
around.
That.
How did it start?
It started as an MC, of course.
Yeah.
12 years I complete being an MC. Never thought I would be one.
Okay.
But I think, you just step. Fumble and just fall somewhere and then you just pick up from there. So that was my journey. I never thought I would be. Opportunity just came in and picked it up from there. Polished myself.
Okay.
Learned on the way and 12
Initially,
years
Initially
you
didn't
now.
Want to be MC.
I never thought that I had the talent of speaking. I used to always run away from mic when it came to speaking.
But you're into singing, dancing and all other activities.
That was always there. Yeah. Now that is sidelined.
Okay. Yeah. Where did you get that confidence like?
That I can talk.
Yeah.
I think it took about at least 3 years to
because
be.
Because it's unbelievable to hear that a person who has done more than 2000 shows didn't have confidence to speak in the beginning.
My school friends were pretty surprised. They were like, I mean, I could imagine you being a choreographer or anything like that, but
exactly.
How did you turn out to be an MC?
Yeah.
So they always make fun of me even now. So, yeah, eventually, with your downfalls and with your mistakes and corrections and learning process, you automatically, and mainly the appreciation that we get from our audience,
you
build up that
confidence.
That's absolutely right.
Exactly.
Yes.
So, during your journey,
as
I usually ask my guest in our episode about their childhood days, how it was, and the selection of stream. With respect to education, since most of our student viewer friends are watching this show, if a person studying in PU would like to take up MC as a profession, then what do you suggest?
Well, if you want to take MCing or anchoring as your profession, it's not necessary that you have to take a particular stream, because as an MC, first thing that you need to do is have the confidence. Have command over language and I think confidence and learning process, that's more important. So maybe you're an engineer or a doctor or an entrepreneur, anything, but you can be an MC as well. So it's not necessary that you need to, choose a particular stream as such. So it's all a different.
But you should have some wow factor.
That you need to improvise on yourself. First thing, you need to discover what is your wow factor, improvise on that and start taking up
Can
that.
Hera Pinto share her wow factor in our show?
I'm still figuring it out.
Okay.
I don't know if I have a wow factor or something like that.
Okay.
I just try to be myself on stage.
Okay.
I try to, if I do a performance or a program, I know I've fumbled somewhere, I've done a mistake. So what I need to do is I need to get back home and then analyze what my mistake is and then correct myself.
Okay.
So improving by the day is a wow factor.
Self-improvement.
Yes, exactly. I think homework is really important to be best on the stage. Yeah.
Did you ever feel that you're not given your best in any show?
Oh, so many times.
Oh.
So many times. Yeah. Because you can't be your 100% all the time.
Okay.
Sometimes there are emotional breakdowns. Maybe something has happened back at home. You need to gather yourself and get on the stage.
Correct.
Or sometimes when you're just getting on the stage, somebody just, oh my God, you've become so fat. It just pulls down your. It actually happened.
It actually happened
recently. And somebody just comes and tells me, I feel so bad. I said, why are you feeling bad? And no, you've lost your figure. I'm like,
just before the show, is it?
Just before the show. It was a big wedding. And I'm like, I didn't know what to say.
Okay.
It was a little later, before I started the program, I just called him. I said, and I just gave my peace of mind. I said, just be a little sensitive in what you have to say.
Correct.
Maybe you could have said in a subtle way or anything. And just not in front of everybody and something like that. And I was almost in tears. So, yeah.
How did you get back then at that moment?
said,
because
okay.
It's getting back into track is a big question.
I know. I mean, yeah. That event was a, it was a success, but still, you know, somewhere when you lose that confidence, your entire, though you're looking the best, you're in the best of your dress, best of the makeup, your self-confidence is super important.
Correct,
so
correct,
people
correct.
Need to be sensitive at times, which people tend not to be.
Because usually MC, you entertain others.
But
many don't know what are the difficulties MC face.
Absolutely.
Right from getting up from the bed, getting ready. And
a lot
then,
of, I'm exactly. sure you get that too.
Would you like to just brief it up? Like,
yeah, like a lot of people must have, you know, told you as well. You know, they tell me every, you know, just an MC, what? You just have to pick up the mic and talk. No, it takes a lot of efforts. You need to prepare yourself. You need to dress yourself. There's so many hours that we put in. Because if our mind is not right, you might just talk some bullshit and just come on stage. But you need to prepare yourself. There's a lot.
Interaction matter a lot.
Exactly.
And we don't know what kind of audience we face.
That's right.
Totally depend on exact date.
And I think when being on stage, you need to coordinate with every person that is around, like, you know, maybe your technical guy, your sound guy, your catering guy, or your dancer, your other artist.
Most important, strangers.
Yeah, exactly. You need to coordinate and put everything in one spot or one line.
Exactly.
So that's very difficult, and the people who are not into that in that day just tell, hey, dada, just pay mic patun ni patir naati atta, kaasu detu ni popini. That's all they say.
But you just need to be like, predict the unpredicted
exactly.
stuff.
Exactly. You just that need to calm your nerves and just do your job and come up.
Okay. Speaking about your life. During your PU days, degree days, graduation days, we know that you are a fashion designer. In fact, we are very happy that, in fact, I am happy that I am sitting in front of a person who has received the best creative design awardee. So, really happy. Congratulations.
Thank you
again.
So much.
But how did it happen? Like, it's fashion designing, during graduation, people would like to go to aviation, some would like to go to banking jobs, some would like to just take the job which comes in their way through placement, and some would like to go for higher education. What was your process over there?
My dream was always to be a air hostess, like when you said aviation, that kind of struck me when I was a kid, because I thought I'll be a great air hostess and all of that, but then eventually, you know, before I got into my real senses, I knew that that was not the kind of job I will be, you know, looking for.
Speaking about real sense.
As in, like, maybe at the age of eight itself, like, you know, when you do not know about your career.
Okay, okay, exactly.
That's what, not, I'm not talking about, like, from cradle to thing, that's age. My grandfather was a tailor. So, you know, whenever he was out of his tailoring room, I used to go and, you know, all this chindi and all, I used to, like, start stitching and make some Barbie dresses out of the socks and all of that. So, from there, I got an interest of, okay, I think I want to be a fashion designer. I made a own book of myself with all my designs when I was in fifth grade or something. And then I just grew up, and I always knew I wanted to go to NIFT after my second PU.
Okay.
But for some reason, I couldn't go there. Everybody were doing my BCom, I mean, their BCom.
Yeah,
so, I also followed the herd. I did my BCom. And then I thought, okay, now what? I'm never going to be a fashion designer. But
an air hostess dream also went off.
That long back
long
when
back.
I was a child itself. Okay, okay. So I said, no, I don't. Because I felt it was quite monotonous. I mean, this is my perspective. So, yeah. And then I thought, okay, I'm not going to be a fashion. I'm not going to pursue that at all. But
now, throughout the journey, you're thinking about the entire decision is taken by you, or were there any guidance?
No. I would say there was no guidance, there was much of obstruction, or what do you say, distraction of my decisions.
Okay.
Because I wanted to do NIFT, you know, my fashion designing in NIFT in Bangalore, but you know, I couldn't.
No guidance, nothing?
Not really. Like I said, I just went with the herd. I said, all my friends are doing BCom, so I also just do BCom and see how that leads up.
But didn't have idea what to do after BCom.
Yeah, exactly. Absolutely no idea.
Okay.
Yeah, but in between the time, what I did is I used to take up the small tailoring classes and you know, the in around Bangalore. And then when I was set in MC, so I took 1 year gap and went to Bangalore. I did my diploma in Vogue Fashion Institute.
Okay.
And that is when I got this best.
During
these
BCom days, were you into all these programs?
I started off when I was in first degree.
Okay.
My first
during your
MC,
first show.
Yeah.
How do you feel?
God, first thing I was like so thin, super skinny,
no
confidence, and it was like a by heart MC. So I had like by hearted the script and gone on the stage.
Nervousness.
Of course. to the peak. Yeah, so that was my first event. I remember I wore a maroon color sari. It was a wedding in Sastan on the 1st of January 2010.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, people who are interested in performing, no problem. But there are a set of students who would like to be MC, but don't know how to go out. So, what do you suggest?
Very
much interested, as you know.
We are blessed, this generation, to have YouTube, we are blessed to have Google.
Yes.
There are so many sources that you can hear, you can watch, you can watch so many MCs. That is how I learned, basically, in the beginning, to gather new ideas, to see new styles.
Yeah.
So, go on YouTube, go on Google,
but
check
But originality matters, right?
Of course. Watch. I'm not telling copy paste. Do not copy paste. See, watch, adapt that and see what new you can do with that. That's more
Improvise.
Important. See, if you're going to just sit and say that, okay, I'm an MC, I'm going to be only doing this. If you don't watch others, you will never know.
Exactly.
So, it's also very important. You can watch, read, write your script, rehearse in front of the mirror and I think that will go on.
That's nice. How was life during fashion designing over there in Bangalore, right?
Yeah. That was 1 year in Bangalore. Monday to Friday in Bangalore, Saturday, Sunday in Mangalore.
Homesickness?
Not homesickness. I'm never homesick, homesick as such. I like to be on my own, like a free bird, you know. I'll manage anyway. But Monday to, why Saturday, Sunday is, I used to come here to host shows. Off season, luckily by God's grace also I had shows out here. So, Monday to Friday I used to do my diploma classes. Friday afternoon take a bus or Friday night take a bus. Saturday, Sunday host a show, tour one. Then again Sunday night go back to Bangalore. Then Monday to Friday. That was my routine for entire 1 year. I was sick because of the water change, the food change and all of that.
Okay.
So it was really terrible but managed, survived.
Did you ever think why did I come to Bangalore?
I wanted, it was my choice.
So, irrespective of however tough it is, you just need to cope up with it.
When you take a stand, you need to stand up for that.
Correct.
There's no looking back.
During those fashion designing, what they teach, did you expect the same thing or was it beyond something else?
For me, it was more of an exposure.
Because it is a practical field, right?
Rather than
more theoretical. I'm just guessing. I don't know much.
It is both. It is both. You need to understand the theory because if this fabric, you need to understand what kind of a fabric it is.
Okay.
How it is done. You know, you need to understand the history,
yes.
the theory, everything. That is also important. I think with every subject, the theory and practicality is super important. Without knowing the theory, you can never get into the practical side of it. So for me, it was a little difficult because I was managing work, I was managing travel, health issues and you know, the assignments were like over the board. It was too much to cope up time and all of that. But it was all worth it. That entire 1 year was a, it was a beautiful journey that transformed my life into, you know, the struggle and then winning that contest and all of that. So it was a beautiful
Speaking
journey.
About the struggle, did you ever have time to spend with your friends?
I always made time that I could, you know, made time to meet my friends. So, the thing about me is if I want something, I will make sure I will get it.
Okay.
So, sometimes I sit at home and I feel super irritated, like you know, I want to go out and I'm feeling caged. So, I'll just get up and go.
Okay.
So,
you call your friends or?
I call my friends or we meet up or we plan some trips. If nobody's coming, I'll just pack my bag, I'll sit on a train and I'll just go to go and relax and come.
Okay.
Yeah.
You told that nobody's coming. But we know that you have lots of friends.
Of course.
I have tried my best to give you some surprise here.
All right.
Let's see.
Hi, Hera. Happy to know you are a part of the Youngest Stars event today. So, viewers out there who are watching the show to know Hera better, I've known Hera since my childhood and she is a super talented woman. She was an athlete, a sportsperson back in school. She was good at singing, dancing. She's an amazing host. I'm sure most of you would know this or would have attended the event she's hosted. So, can't think of anything she's bad at actually. No, she was very bad at accounts in college. So anyway, on a serious note, we are each other's go-to person always. And recently I had my wedding gown designed by her. She did an amazing job. So anybody out there who is looking out for a customized outfit, I'd really recommend Hera as a designer. She is fabulous at this job, and I'm sure you won't be disappointed. So yes, Hera, good luck with the show. Have fun. Bye.
Oh, that was such a surprise.
Go-to person.
Thank you, Jumbo. Sorry, Roshni.
So, I tried my best to get your go-to person only.
Oh, that is so sweet. Thank you. Let him cry.
She was just thinking what you're bad at, actually.
Yeah.
Also, she told that you're a super talented person. That is what I mentioned in the beginning also. Mm-hmm. That's nice.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of friends. Let's see who's next.
You have more?
We'll see. Yeah, we'll see.
Okay.
One more. Because you have a lot of friends.
Hi, I'm Natasha. I know Hera since 2008. We've been best of best friends, more like soul sisters, I can say. We are five friends, and Hera has always been with us more in our not so good times and good times. Like, you know, she's that one friend who will come to you in whatever your situation is. I'm so lucky to have a friend like her. She's really a true friend, I can say. Hera has been always this talented girl into singing, dancing, MCing. Of course, whatever she is doing now, that is MCing, it all began back then in our college days, where, you know, she used to do these events for our college fest. And I feel so proud to see her achieving all her dreams and shining. Bilu, from the heart, I wish you nothing but the best. Natu loves you. Take care. And I'm proud of you.
Thank you, Natu. That was really sweet too.
Yeah. So, she told that. You are one friend.
Mm-hmm.
At any time she call, you'll be going there.
Yeah, yeah.
So,
these are really, yeah. I mean, the other two are missing.
She told five friends, but I couldn't reach all, everyone.
Okay.
So, some other day, some other show, we'll try to get another three friends of yours.
For sure. Yeah.
Any setbacks when you speak about your life?
Of course, there are always setbacks. And I believe that you need to have setbacks. You can't have a rose of, you know, a bed of rose every time.
Exactly.
A setback is very important because they say, right, the lion takes the tiger or lion. Somebody, one of them.
Animal.
Yeah, takes like one step behind to pounce again back.
Okay. Yeah,
so I think setbacks are, I always say that every human is flawed and being flawed is beautiful when you flaunt it.
Oh, that's nice.
So so I believe in that. If you, everybody has setbacks, everybody has you know, a flaw in their life.
Yes.
But when you accept it and, you know, you're up there.
Correct.
So I think that's beautiful and nobody can shake you after that.
That's nice.
Yeah.
We know that you have hosted more than 2000 shows.
Mm-hmm.
Can we have a small, I cannot get some clippings here.
Yeah,
but
you can Google
for your friends. Yeah.
You can YouTube link.
But in our show,
yeah.
Some of the, where you need to introduce a person.
Okay.
Or you need to introduce a gathering, some chief guest or something like that. Jalak of different stuffs.
Different stuff. See, my forte is weddings. I enjoy and I love doing weddings because.
How do you start? It's okay. Start in your own way.
Okay. A very good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the new beginnings of Abhilash and...
No. Yet to.
Somebody else?
No.
No, I'm just Jalak. Works on reality.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, suggest me a name, Abhilash.
Okay, we'll go to the next one. Yeah. Next, other than wedding?
Other than wedding. God, you're really putting me into a spot.
Yeah.
When I actually have the mic in the hand, that you know, the real MC thing.
There's no
automatically
mic
comes.
Here, no.
And also, I do all of this only when I'm getting paid.
Okay, we'll speak about it later. Is there any instance where you're hosted in Kannada?
Kannada. A lot of people, if you're Shutterbox Sachin Shetty's fans, you will know that how amazing and excellent my Kannada and Tulu is.
You know Kannada?
Yeah, Kannada barate nange nange maatadlikke
salpa aache
aagtade aache salpa alla tumba aache aagtade because I studied in MRPL school and we didn't have that basic, we just
Kannada.
Had very basic Kannada. So I didn't speak to, when I was a kid back then, my neighbors used to ask me, Amma alli dare, Amma alli de. So that's how we used to talk, and I've never tried improving the language.
Okay.
My fault.
There was no requirement, I guess. Not much.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Tulu also, I was super bad. I could not even understand. Only after I joined Aloysius, then I know.
Hosted shows in Tulu?
No.
Yet to.
Never. Okay. Kannada was funny. So this client booked me for an event in Koppa. It was a rose event, the Haldi ceremonies and the rose event. And I told them, okay, I'm sure there's no Kannada, right? I mean, are you sure there's no Kannada? They said, no, only English and Konkani and all that. So when I reached there and I started off, I see more than 60% of the people are Koppa people.
Okay.
And they wouldn't understand English and Konkani, of course. Now, as an MC, it is my job for them to understand what
You're
I'm trying to
MC,
say.
Right?
I'm the only MC there.
Huh.
God, at least now I can try. It was like many years back. And I said some sentence. People started laughing. Literally, people are on the floor laughing.
What was the sentence?
I have no idea. I can't remember now. Everybody is laughing. And after that, they became fans of my Kannada, like the funny Kannada, and they did not let me speak any other language, Kannada, talking Kannada. And I was so embarrassed. And it was funny. I was also laughing. But what I realized it is very wrong on my part, you know, to, if I do not know the language, I should not talk. If I'm a comedian, if I'm doing something, that's another thing.
Correct.
But as an MC, I was somewhere, you know, insulting the language and not respecting the language.
But you didn't know, right?
I didn't know. After that, I stopped talking Kannada. Okay. So even if a client asked me like 20% Kannada, I said, I'm really sorry. So unless and until I'm very 100%, I will definitely not take an event. So that Koppa dalli Kannada, one story. Mine.
Once in a lifetime.
Yeah.
That's
something
nice
to remember though. Yeah.
If I ask you to choose one among the two, MC or fashion designer, what would you choose? Only one.
Sure. I would love to be a fashion designer, but on a greater scale than what I am right now. I'm just a beginner. Like, you know, I've done all these courses in a long year, many years back, but I haven't given my time into it.
Okay.
But I really want to be a greater fashion designer.
Okay. Future plans would be to become a greater fashion designer.
In the process.
Anything to be revealed in front of your friends?
Nothing yet.
Secret?
Nothing. Just support me and on my journey, just support me. And never stop believing in me.
Because people say, right, work hard in silence and success.
Yeah, success. That's right. True that.
We'll see. Someday. Surely. Yes. We need support from family. So, can we have one surprise?
Another surprise,
if you don't mind.
For sure, I love surprises.
Yeah, but this is an interesting surprise.
Okay.
Important, interesting surprise.
All right, let's see.
Hello, Hera. I'm really happy and excited to see you on this platform, where you can be a real inspiration to many. About Hera, she's an amazing personality, inside out. I would say she's like an Avenger, who always fights for right and never gives up. I'm really happy to see you here, inspiring people like real youngsters and women of today's generation. You know, wherever you used to go out, people will tell you how lucky you are to have me as a partner. But today I'll tell you, I'm so proud of you and have you as my partner. So keep working hard, keep climbing the ladder of success, keep inspiring people. Cheers.
Oh.
Today he's telling. Did he tell at home?
Actually, that was the only thing I captured. Today I tell.
Yeah, very important. Right? How did this happen? Can I ask? Or?
Yeah, for sure. I would love to share this story of ours because I believe, you know, if you're destined for something, it will always get to you.
Okay.
So this is one, I call it divine intervention about how we met. So it was about a year back, me and my friend Shravan, we were, you know, we visited the Kadri temple and then it was the Kadri temple feast and also the infant Jesus, the feast. So we visited the Kadri temple and then we came to infant Jesus just for the shrine visit.
Okay.
And we were just heading back and I just saw somebody, not the face, but a side profile and, you know, body and all of that.
Okay.
And I said, Shravana, toipalare, what a personality, you know, he needs to, like, people like that, she needs to be my boyfriend. I said something like that. And then my friend said, like, should I go and talk? I said, it's okay, leave it like this, let's come. Exactly 2 days later, there was a wedding that I was hosting.
Okay.
Everybody knows Joyless, right, the politician. Yeah. So, it was Joyless' wedding and I was the host. And Lloyd happens to be the best man.
Okay.
Out of nowhere, I don't know him, he doesn't know me. Now, I'm not very sure because I hadn't registered the face. So, after the wedding, and also my friend Shravan was also the invitee for the wedding.
During the wedding, the host performance was above average?
I think I did a great job.
Okay.
Yeah. No, but when I'm performing, I didn't concentrate on, you know,
on
who this person could be. Before the program started, I was like, okay, you know, looks like the same guy and all of that. So, but after the event, I just went, and spoke to him at the bar counter there. I said, hi, Lloyd, you know, were you, I just started talking to him and then eventually I just slid in this question. Were you at Infant Jesus wearing a light blue shirt, white shoes, you know, some days, 2 days ago? It's like, yeah, why are you asking me? You with some elderly lady, huh, yeah, my mom, I was there at, like, what time? Like, 1:30. And then Shravana, the same boy. So, that is how we spoke, we connected and so I was like, Infant Jesus sent me, you know, too quickly.
Did you pray before? No.
No, I just said, oh, that needs to be my boyfriend at Infant Jesus. All. So, Infant Jesus is like, enough waiting, okay, take.
That's so really that's a wonderful story to hear. Right?
Yes.
Yes, that's nice. Coming to the conclusion of our talk show, it was really nice to hear you.
Thank you.
It would be great to hear you more also, but our talk show is just half an hour.
Yes.
So, usually I ask my guest to give final message to our viewer friends who are watching this show.
Yes, for sure. Firstly, thank you for having me on this show. It was such
so
a pleasure. And to all of you who are watching this show, I always give only one message. Never give up. Never give up. Of course, downfalls will come. Everybody is going to knock you. Nobody is going to trust you. Nobody is going to have your back all the time. But you need to be believing in yourself. Do the hard work. Do your homework. If you just let it be, you know, if you just say, let it be, okay, let's see tomorrow, let's see tomorrow, that's not going to work. You need to sit down, work for yourself, improve yourself. But whenever there's something wrong happening, that is only a learning process for you. So, learn from the bad that has happened, take the good out of it and just move forward. Believe in yourself and try achieving your dreams, at least a little, but just keep going forward. That's all I love to say. Thank you.
Thank you so much. One message. I think the message was a bigger message.
I'm sorry, the time exceeded.
No, that's really inspiring also and meaningful message. That is what matters a lot. We don't have much to give, but as a token of love, respect and appreciation, a small memento from our side.
Yes. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Also, we have our wardrobe courtesy, Designer Mantra.
Oh, lovely.
So, Designer Mantra opposite City Center.
A
small gift from Designer Mantra.
Thank you, Designer Mantra.
Yes,
and thank you
so much. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, Hera Pinto. My dear viewer friends, it was Hera Pinto, MC, with us today. See you in our next episode. Till then, thank you.